This video will help answer your questions on how to complete the KDP tax interview and why this information is necessary to publish on KDP. Don't worry about taking notes when you're watching. The link to a step-by-step printout is available in the description for this video. So why is the tax interview necessary? Once your book is published and readers begin purchasing your book, you will earn royalties for books sold through Amazon. These royalties are considered income. This income may be subject to 30% U.S. tax withholding. Completing the tax interview allows you to establish your non-U.S. status and also claim a decreased withholding rate if your country of tax residence has a treaty with the U.S. In this video, we will illustrate the steps for how a non-U.S. publisher might complete the tax interview as a resident of the United Kingdom. To answer specific tax questions, we suggest reaching out to a tax professional. If you have a taxpayer identification number, or TIN, you'll need to have that handy. So let's walk through completing the tax interview. The tax interview is located in your account just below your payment and banking information. You'll start by clicking on the Complete Tax Information button, which will take you to the tax information interview. The first question you'll need to answer is, who will receive income from Amazon or its subsidiary? There are two options, individual sole proprietor and business. For this video, we will assume that I'm an author publishing my own work, so I'll select individual sole proprietor. Next, you'll indicate whether or not you are a U.S. person according to how you file your taxes. For this video, we will focus on non-U.S. publishers, so we will select No, then click Save and Continue. If you're a U.S. publisher, please watch our tax video for U.S. publishers. The link to that video is in the description below. The next screen will gather information required to complete an IRS W8 form. This includes the type of beneficial owner and your country of citizenship or residence for tax purposes. For this video, we will illustrate an individual beneficial owner who is a resident of the United Kingdom. Next, you'll enter your full name, your permanent address, and your mailing address, if this is different than your permanent address. For more information on each of these fields, you'll click on the More Information links. The next question asks, if you're acting as an intermediary, since we are illustrating an interview for an individual, we'll answer No. When you click No, two more sections will appear. The first, U.S. Persons Test, asks questions that are required in order for us to ensure that you're completing the right type of tax form. Check any that may apply to you. For this illustration, we're saying that none apply and we will not check any of the boxes. The second section is to indicate the type of tax identification number, or TIN, you may have. You can indicate whether you have a U.S. TIN, a foreign TIN, or both. You can also indicate that you do not have a TIN. If your country has a tax treaty with the U.S., you'll need to enter a TIN in order to be eligible for a decreased withholding rate. For illustration purposes, we will select that we have a foreign TIN, and then we will click Save and Continue. The next section is for treaty benefits. This appears because we previously indicated that our country of tax residence was the United Kingdom, and the UK has an active income tax treaty with the US. In this section, you'll need to confirm your country of residence and indicate whether you qualify as a resident for tax purposes. There is a link to the IRS website which includes more information and additional links to the tax treaty. Please review and consult with your tax advisor if unsure whether you're eligible. For purposes of this video, we'll check the box to indicate that we have reviewed the treaty and qualify for treaty benefits. The following section is where you would enter the foreign tax identification number we selected on the previous screen. Please ensure the number entered is correct and confirm by clicking the checkbox underneath. Then click Save and Continue. The next screen shows two important review sections. The first section shows a U.S. withholding rate that would be applied to your royalty payments as a result of the interview entries. Since we included a foreign TIN and claimed treaty benefits, you will see that this shows 0%. If you were not a resident of a treaty country and did not include a TIN or did not successfully claim treaty benefits, this rate would show 30%. The next section is a review of the completed tax form, which in this case is an IRS form W8BEN. This is your opportunity to review your inputs prior to submission to make sure everything was entered correctly. While you cannot correct anything directly on this page, if there are any incorrect entries, you can click on Previous to go back and edit your inputs. In this case, we will review our inputs and then click Save and Continue. You will then choose if you want to receive a copy of your 1042-S form electronically or by mail. We will click on Go Paperless in order to indicate that we want to receive the tax form electronically. You'll be asked if you consent to provide your electronic signature online. If you click Yes, you'll be required to read and acknowledge each of the qualifiers before you electronically sign the form. If you click No, then you will need to print out a copy of the completed tax interview and mail the physical copy to the address listed on the following page. A warning will pop up indicating that it may take up to 7 days for the form to be processed once it's received by KDP. Click OK to move forward. You will then click the Submit button to complete the interview. Here, you'll see the completed tax form with the information you've provided. You'll click on Exit Interview to complete your tax interview process. You're done setting up your account and you're ready to begin setting up your ebook and paperback titles. Happy publishing!